First class place to do fights. I love coming up here. We'll be back up here February 20th for the first round of the heavyweights for boxing. You have any questions about the fight tonight? It's probably not me, but I'll answer them. I'd like to bring up Taras Seleshchuk. He's the 2012 Olympic bronze medalist from Ukraine. If you all saw his fight tonight, I think it was a minute and a half, but he knocked the guy out pretty bottom. Want to bring up Taras and I think manager of the year of boxing, Vadim Kornilov. Vadim, Taras?
Hello everyone, thank you for coming, thank you Turning Stone, I like this place and I came for to fight and to fight Jim in the first round and I come out and I will be back and I hope I will win in my first belt in this casino, in this place. Thank you so much everyone, good night.
Thank you guys, I'm happy to be here again. We've got so many fighters fight here. It's one of the best places to come. You know, every time we find out that there's a fight at Turning Stone, we're always very positive, very happy. All the ESPN fights that have been here went very well for our team. And I'm glad I don't have to translate for this guy. All my other fighters have to translate for, and so Taras can speak for himself. So it makes me happy. Thank you guys, it was a great night. I appreciate it.
I also want to bring up Brandon Adams, who's already actually on stage. This guy's going to be a star in boxing. He's good looking, he's strong, you know, we had four amateur fights. And he's going to be in the Boxing of 2015, 154 pound division. So this is a guy on the rise. Fighting Alex Perez, and I believe Boxrec is in a five-star fight, so personally, I'd much rather have it in the finals, but they take it in the first round. So without further ado, here's Brandon Adams.
Hi, everyone. I felt good, I felt strong, but it's a long time coming, so I just anxious to get out there.
Brandon, how do you feel after the layoff that's made since you fought Willie? Is that the longest layoff you've had?
Absolutely.
Do you feel any ring rust? I mean, you didn't get too much of a chance.
It didn't catch me.
Back here.
Not what you were busy with.
Yeah, I was busy with my son. Between him and training, that kept me sharp.
How do you feel? So you're going to be going down to 154?
Uh-huh.
How do you feel about that?
I'm excited. That's the weight that I used to fight at before the boxing tournament. So going back down, it definitely won't be a problem. And I'm excited. I'm excited to go back to fighting at 154.
It seems like an easy win for you. You went out there, you dominated. How did you feel?
Figuring him out, trying to see exactly what he wanted to do. I knew what I wanted to do. I wanted to see if he wanted to actually trade punches with me or if he was going to try to use his left. And in my training camp, we were preparing for either way. So, which gym I train out of? Well, I train out of a few gyms. I train out of Broadway Boxing Gym, Maywood Boxing Club, Anderson Silva's Muay Thai Boxing College, another gym called The Rock, gym called Pound for Pound, so I just kind of like, just drift. Boxing tournament, and after the boxing tournament, I would like to stay busy, of course, and try to stay active.
How is it for you coming out now? You've had two fights in a row out here on the East Coast. It's like to be able to fight back in front of your fans out in California?
When you build up a crowd, I mean, a fan base, I'm sure don't mind when you fight. I felt tonight I had a lot of energy, the same energy William Monroe had. So I felt good fighting out here. I'm looking forward to fighting back in California, of course, but I don't mind where I fight.
Names that
won't come before,
like,
I don't mind. I never really think about who I'm going to fight. Once they tell me the person's name, then they become the designated target. But I'm just up the mat now, so I don't.
Okay. Any other questions?
Thank you.
I got a question. When are you going to Disneyland?
Shut up.
Yeah. I don't like rides.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I want to bring up our next star, Baron Promotions. He's Usamino Freitas' nephew, Vitor Jones, De Oliveira Freitas.
Good evening, everyone. Estou muito feliz de ter voltado para cá. Voltei aqui ano passado, ganhei e fico muito contente porque todos me receberam com os braços abertos e estão me passando mais. Não posso dizer, mas muita experiência que eu estou pegando, né?
I'm very happy to be back here. I fought here last year and I won. And there's a lot of good energy here and I'm receiving a lot of experience fighting here in the United States.
Através de Milton Popó, Acelino Popó Freitas e Luiz Cláudio Freitas, que eu iniciei no boxe. E graças a Deus eu estou onde eu estou hoje. E a minha meta é ser campeão mundial.
Through my uncles, Casimino Popo Freitas and Luis Claudio Freitas, I've gotten to where I am today, and my goal is to be a world champion.
Agradeço a todos pelo evento que teve e pelo apoio de cada um de vocês. Estou muito feliz de lutar aqui em Nova York, em Verona, e espero vir aqui mais vezes.
Thank you all for your support. I'm very happy to be fighting here in Verona, New York, and I hope to be back soon.
Vitor, even though your fight only went not even a minute and a half, it seemed like your opponent Doyle did come out with a really fast jab. Did you even have a little bit of concerns that you were going to have to deal with his feet?
Não tive preocupação nenhuma, entrei já no ringue aceso, porque pelo que ia acontecer, eu assisti o vídeo da luta dele lutando. Então, quando a gente sobe do ringue, a gente tem que estar o tempo todo focado, porque senão, um piscar de olhar, se pode tomar um knockdown e acabar com a luta. Então eu estava muito confiante, muito bem treinado e graças a Deus saí com a vitória. Não teve preocupação nenhuma.
I trained very hard for this fight and I was very focused. In a fight you have to be 100% there at all times. If not in the blink of an eye, you can lose it. I worked very hard for this and I watched my opponent's fights, so I was ready.
Obrigado a todos. Espero vir aqui mais vezes.
Thank you very much, everyone. I hope to come back soon.
Willie Monroe just finished his post-fight drug test. He's coming in after he gets through his fans. Damian? Well, what did you guys think of the fight? I personally thought it was closer than the score.
I think the matchmaker did a hell of a job.
Okay.
You should keep him through a long-term contract.
That's exciting.
Harry.
His name?
What's that, Jack?
I don't know what his name is, but...
Next question.
So how close did you want to fight? Because I don't get it.
No, I thought Vera won about 3 rounds. I think with the knockdown, you know, he was pressing the action. Personally, I think anyone that's pressing the action... Yeah, that's true.
Do you think it was a real knockdown?
What's that?
Do you think it was a real knockdown? It's kind of hard to tell from our angle.
It was a close judgment call, and you know, the ref made his decision. So I could see it either way. So, hopefully we'll have Willie fighting in a big fight coming up in the next 4 months. So that's the game plan.
And you had it the other way.
You seem to be coming up here quite a bit. Is that going to be the ongoing stories?
Yeah, well, we're here February 20th for Boxing Up. So it's a great place to do fights.
I love it. Is
the date after February 20th?
Not right now. Yeah, I just want to reiterate how great it is doing shows here because of Ed Altman, Heidi Strong, Sonny, the whole staff's top notch.
Oh my gosh.
And finally, here's the star of the night, Willie Monroe. Willie.
I got fans and family. They can't like come in and stand in the back and just view. Quite for themselves.
Oh, yeah.
It's like fans and family out here that like they bought tickets. It's a group of people. They bought tickets, man. These people like.
They stay back there.
Yeah, my people really want. I don't want
to. Yeah, well,
no, I'm trying to give it to them.
So they can't just come and stand in.
No, we'll get them in. Just come up here. I'll get them in.
Don't want them to come to the press.
I don't want to be anal about it, but I mean, when people come out here, they get tickets, come to see you do things. They you know, show up. That's how you keep fans.
Hey,
Willie.
No one wants to speak to me.
I'm real from the bottom to the top, man. I'm not about to, you know, market and get these people to buy tickets to come out here and tell them, get out of my face, you know? I'm real dude. And these people really support a champion from upstate New York. So just give them an opportunity to see what's going on, you know? It's just the things they want to be a part of. They're fans. They're a big part of making this show successful. And all those screaming fans out there, they didn't just come to see me fight and walk. It's cold out there. Let the people that's out there come in and hear the champion talk. They came out here for, you know, the show will build up. It's only, what is this press conference? 15, 20 minutes.
Give
Matt
a couple minutes, let's see what he does.
Yeah, it's only 15, 20 minutes. They don't come in, man. Those people pay, they work jobs, they pay money, they get inside tickets, they make the show a success. Give Matt a little bit of love, it's only 15, 20 minutes.
Willie, yes? want to talk about the fight a little bit and what you expected coming in and what actually was different in the fight that happened?
He's a smooth criminal. He took me clean off the subject. Yeah. You
know? but everyone wants to hear about the fight too.
It was a great fight. It was what I expected. A really, really tough fight from Ryan Vera. I'm not gonna lie. When the fight was first mentioned to us, I was kind of iffy about taking it because I'm just like, this guy's fought a who's who boxer. He's, you know, he fought Chavez twice and beat Chavez the first time and then took it from him. So for me to go in there and fight somebody like Ryan Vera was a huge test. Yes, he's my biggest test so far. I mean, you're talking about punching power, the ability to survive. I caught him with a couple of hard shots, and he was able to survive. You know, and I had to use my smarts to step back and start over from the bottom again. But, I mean, like, you're looking at somebody who's been, like I said, who's been in there with the who's who, and who has fought a little bit at everybody. And, I mean, he was laughing at me a lot of times when I hit him with some hard shots. Like, even though I know they were hurting, he knows what's going on. I mean, like, he's been around the block a few times. He's saying this first rodeo, so.
You looked good. I thought you were really easy. You took it slow. You picked your shots. How were you feeling?
That's what I plan to do. Somebody rough like Ryan Buren, rough and tough, and who can take a shot and deliver a big shot. You can't be in there just allowing him to hit you and going back and forth, because before you know it, the seventh round will come, you'll be dead tired and your body will be beat up. So I just took him for a walk. Took him for a walk and walked him into shots like a technician would do.
How did you feel mentally coming back
to the ring after so much walk? That really didn't bother me because I live in the gym. You know, I'm not, you know, you have your great fighters, Andre Ward, Ricky Leal, Floyd Mayweather. These guys are not just great because they're tremendous athletes. They take their job, their profession very serious. So in between fights, they're in the gym. And that's one quality that I was raised with my grandfather, who everybody knew was Afro-Cuban, and he was very strict on me when it came to boxing, so my work ethic is second to none. So I mean, I could have been out a whole year, I still would have been sharp because I live in the gym.
Willie, a couple times, you kind of had your back to the ropes, you motioned him in, you rumbled a little bit. Did you ever feel like you were taking a risk you shouldn't have, or did you feel at that point you taking the best you had, you weren't worried about it?
Nah, it's all about intelligence. You know what I mean? You have to use every little bit that you have in the ring. And just like the fight before this, when I fought Brandon Adams, the conventional wisdom was, Adams get on the inside, Monroe's gonna be in trouble if anybody saw me watch on the inside. But they saw me execute on the inside. So, I mean, like, I fight well on the inside or the outside. So I just wanted to mix it up a little bit, give the crowd a little bit, and enjoy what I was doing. I connected on a couple shots, but it was, I can't lie, it had a lot to do with me making him miss and being off balance and then catching him while he was off balance. So, but I mean, a knockdown is a knockdown, whether it's a flash knockdown or you hurt somebody when you knock him down. I mean, the name of the game is a hit and don't get hit. So I caught him with a couple shots, made him miss, and it was off balance, caught him with something else, and you know, his glove touched the ground. His, you know, his behind didn't touch the ground officially, but when your glove touched the ground, it's official knockdown.
All right, Randy from the calendar. I noticed you were taking a lot of shots, hitting him with a lot of face shots. Any reason why you didn't go to the body?
He was good at protecting his body because he heard, I'm pretty sure he heard us say, a couple left hands I landed to the body, my up, down, my hook to the head, hook to the body, I landed real well. But he was good at on the inside, like more or less bending over and protecting his body. That's why when I was laying on the ropes, I motioned him in so I could bait him in for a body shot. But I mean, I take what's given, you know what I mean? I'm not going to press the issue and try to get to the body when a guy is really covering his body. I'm going to start touching the head, and then he's going to start trying to cover his head, then we'll bring it out to the body. Yeah. It's boxing IQ. The sky's the limit. You know, I'm not one of those guys get out here and start calling out fighters and saying, I want this guy, I want that guy. That's just never been my forte as a fighter. But one thing I will say is being signed to a great promoter like Artie Palullo, we're sitting right on the middle of the fence. So you're not going to see Willie Monroe out here on one side of the fence hiding behind my promoter, my advisor, saying, I want to fight this guy, I want to fight that guy. But knowing because of network situations, promotional situations, advisor situation that I won't get to fight him. I'm sitting right on the middle of the fence. So if they say, let's go left and take some belts, sign me up, we're going to go get them belts. If they say, go right and get some belts, we're going to go right and we're going to get them belts.
Well, right now you're highly ranked in the WBA and the WBO, the two champions. Of course, you can highly love it. And new WBO champion, talk about proxy intelligence, and I'm sure you study these guys.
Right.
Who do you think you would match up better against?
I think both of them. Andy Lee's a tall southpaw. And I can be, you guys have seen that I can be the aggressor. And, you know, I think my short shots that we've been working over the top with my trainer, my head trainer, Tony Morgan, will be effective. And I was just happy to get inside his leg. And who wouldn't want to see a powerhouse like Triple G, you know, getting there with the rabbit man, so to speak? That'd be like Sugar Ray Leonard versus Marvin Hagler. So, I mean, you have that old definitive slick boxer versus train. So I mean, it's a matchup and a contrasting styles that can make for spontaneous combustion. So I think both of those fights are good. Then there's other middleweights out there. Like I said, I'm not gonna call out any middleweights. I'm gonna sit here, you know, lick my chops and look at what's good out there. You know, pick the right foot when it's right.
So if you were offered either a were those guys in your very next fight? You wouldn't hesitate or want to come with one more time?
I wouldn't hesitate to fight. I wouldn't hesitate to fight anybody. But at the end of the day, we know boxing is business. So we gotta make sure the numbers is right, the networks is right, the money is right. If you get up here and say, I'll fight anybody, anywhere, anytime, they'll be like, okay, we're gonna offer you this just because it's, at the end of the day, I'm still in business.
After you won the tournament, you mentioned that you were moving down to 150 before. Why did you move down? Do you feel that you have more opportunities at 160, or would you feel comfortable moving down to 150?
A little bit. That's why. I like my cake. Now, I like my jump school, but actually, my strength and conditioning coach right here, Lee Davis, we were in the gym and we were training, and we said, look, you know, the NABA and the NABO act. So why don't you go ahead and put on a little more extra weight, a little more muscle, and be able to bang with the big boys and stay up to it. Right? Eat however I don't got to really, like, really, really dehydrate to make 160. I can be comfortable in training camp, and you know, we can be strong. And it's a weight class that I can really grow into. I have the frame, and I can definitely grow into a strong middleweight.
Any other questions for Willie?
You got something for Triple G?
Do I have something for Triple G? When we finally do meet Triple G, it's time for going, going, going. But I respect every fight. You know, I get a lot of slack. It's funny because when you got guys who don't want to fight big fighters, they say, oh, he's scared, he's not a real fighter. You get a guy like me who say, I'll fight him. They say, you're crazy, you're stupid. How could you ever expect to beat him? They can't win for losing. But I mean, Willie Monroe's a key player in the middleweight division right now. And it's about to be real, real interesting.
It's just more playing all the whole time.
You speak up.
That's it.
Obviously, up on stage is Brian Vera, a true warrior in the sport. And I've paid money each time we have played in our play.
Give this man another round of applause, please.
I must say, Dave Blatson and Brian Vera are two of the most pleasant people to work with in the business, and I really genuinely like these two men. They're had some fun times, I don't think. So they're not over, no way. So here's Brian Vera.
Hey. Brian, where would you rate Willie? A lot of top guys, everybody knows you drive into the first fight at least. Beat Zinjar, former world champion, took him apart. Where would you put Willie?
I mean, he fought a great fight. He fought smart. He's probably the best boxer as far as his mover and slick skills that I've ever fought. I mean, he fought an intelligent fight. He didn't want to stay there bank too long. You know, I was trying to work, make it rough. He grabbed me at times. And he was smart, man. I got to give it to him. I thought it was a lot closer than what he said, but at the end of the day, I came to his hometown. I don't know how to dodge nobody. I try to fight everybody. So I still don't think I'm done yet. I thought I did enough to where I'm still a problem in this division. So we'll see what happens.
In the fourth round, you did a lot of work on his body, and it was probably your best round of the fight. Was the rest of the fight at least not being able to pick him down to do that?
Yeah, I was trying to position myself many times to get close. Like I said, he was just being smart, grabbed me, he was moving, he was slick, and I was trying to get him in the corner at times and bang away. I was trying to make it ugly, you know, make him ugly fight. And at times I had him thinking about doing it, and he would do it for a minute, and then he'd get out. So, you know, I was just trying, I think I was being over aggressive.
What was your opinion of what happened with Enzius, calling that a knockdown?
Oh, I just really thought that was silly, man. Because, you know, everybody saw that I tripped up, you know what I mean? I got off balance, he turned on me. I was in the corner trying to turn around. I slipped, caught myself in my hand a little bit. So it's rules, though, you know, the rules is that you touch the ground to go up and it's not there. So I can't really complain too much.
You didn't feel a punch
positive? No, absolutely not. It wasn't a knockdown, but, you know, it's just rules.
Where do you go from here? Do you want to stay in the middleweight division or, you know, depending on the offer, move up?
Yeah, it depends. I'm strong enough to fight super middleweight as well. You know, I think that super middleweight, I'm stronger. I get to carry the weight, carry the strength. 60 really is tough for me to make. If a good fight comes at 60, then I can always come back down and make it. But if a great offer comes at 68, then I'll take it. You know, I'm willing to fight a bulk. Oh, you know, he, like I said, he's smart, he's slick, he's got a bigger punch. You know, I've dealt with big punches before. Chavez Jr. is a big guy, he can punch. He wasn't able to really hurt me too much. You know, he caught me with flush shots. I think everybody I fought caught me with a flush shot once or twice. And, but he was smart and slick, and he caught me off guard a couple times, but never was I hurt. Yeah, I was trying to make it to where somebody won since they lost. You know, maybe my team's not a little kid, so I was trying to ride Dalvin.
Speaking of the Cowboys, what did you think of that
play
last week?
Oh, he's a touchdown. It was definitely a touchdown. So, but it is what it is. Just like the knockdown. Yeah. I'm just gonna go back to the drawing board on my team and see what happens. I still got something in me, you know what I mean? I'm not done yet. This won't be the last time they see me this year, so I hope to get back in the ring soon. I didn't feel like I got damaged at all in the fight. Like I said, he fought a smart fight, but I don't feel like I got banged around or nothing. I better hop right back in. So hopefully they put me right back on.
How are you at middleweight? Are you more comfortable with
the higher weight? I'm definitely more comfortable at 168 because it's a lot easier to make. I'm getting older now, you know, I'm 33, so 160 is getting a little bit tougher. But like I was telling this guy earlier, I'll take either one. You know, it just depends on what the offer is and when the fight. And we'll just have to see what happens.
Brian, so far you're 2-2 up here at the turning stone. Would you like to come back for a fifth time?
I think I'm 3-1, but, you know, it is what it is. Yeah, absolutely. You know, it's a good place to fight. They treat us well. Grant promotions like their home. You know, I'm with them, so I love coming here. Everybody treats us well. Like I was saying earlier, we try to respect as well. So as long as y'all keep happening, we'll keep coming.
Would you rather be in the summer instead of this time of year?
We always get stuck out here this time of year. Man. It seems like unless it's year round like this, you know what I mean? So. This is a change for us. It's definitely different than Texas.
Any other questions for Brian?
Thank you.
Again, in closing, I just want to thank Ed Altman, Heidi Strong, everyone at Turning Stone, and come back out February 20th for the Boxing Tournament in the heavyweight division. So, see you at the fights.